even in the music video, you can try to go a year of semen retention, but if you are coming in agreement with that rapper talking about the lustful actions towards a female, right? And not respecting the female in a way where you're calling her outside of her name, brother, it's gonna be tough for you to go and respect females. It's gonna be tough for you to respect yourself. You know what I mean? And respect your life force, bruh. What's going on, brothers of YouTube? Elijah here, back here with another video. Guys, let's be honest here, man. Isn't this a shocker, bruh? Your boy Elijah almost relapsed. Brother Elijah almost relapsed, man. It's a very shocker, but at the same time, I must humble myself and tell you guys the real reason why I almost did so. As you guys can see, there's a big effect going on and a big transition in this world with the coronavirus. And a lot of individuals are transferring inside their house. And I want to tell you guys the big things that can help you out while on semen retention. Now, I let my mind get comfortable. And these are things that you still must implement from day one to 3 years of semen retention to make this lifestyle in order for you to really, you know, get your true effect of semen retention, okay? So it's going right to the video. So guys, okay, I'm gonna be very clear with you. The real reason why I almost relapsed, guys, I'm currently on day 439, and I was almost about to relapse on day 434, right? So a couple days ago, I almost relapsed. And the real reason why was because I had an idle mind. Guys, when you have an idle mind, now this thing it says in the Bible, it says Proverbs 16-27, an idle hands are the devil's workshop, right? So, guys, when you are not having a clear vision and when you're not staying productive in the middle of the day and you are staying almost too comfortable, that's where the devil will come in and try to put visualizations and put a feeling inside of you to make you relapse. So it's only a must for us to stay productive. You know what I mean? It's a must for us to stay productive. And even while you're in this house, guys, do something productive so you can keep your mind off of it. Because when you are in your bed, think about this. You're in your bed at 2 p.m., right? You're a young kid, and you're in your bed just relaxing, okay? Let's be honest here. You put in the comments down below. Will your chances of relapsing become higher or lower, right? It's gonna become a lot higher, right? So, being very productive and doing whatever it is that you want to do in life. Now, some of the events may be outside. Some of the events may be fitness. Guys, go to your living room and hit a workout, so on and so forth. But do anything to keep your mind off of this journey, or keep your mind off of this. Off of ejaculating, you know, off of masturbating. Second of all, vision. I'm gonna be very clear with you, man. The word of God is very real, okay? But also science and the Bible can correlate with each other, guys. As you guys can see, the news and television is part of the matrix. Television is to tell a live vision, meaning they're gonna put a vision inside of you, putting a false vision, so that way, when it comes inside of your mind, you can betray that out, okay? So, having a false vision that's outside of the Word of God, that's demonic, right? Anything that's outside of the Word of God and anything that's portraying the opposite of the Word of God is very demonic. The music industry and the vision, right? The music industry is very demonic. So when you see these music videos, let's say that you like a rapper, right? And you see a music video, and the music video is discussing a lustful action towards a female. And you like the rapper and you like his music. If you keep listening to it and you come in agreement with him, then, brother, if you come in agreement with something and you honestly agree, like, yo, this goes hard. I smashed two females, boom, 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 so on and so forth. Okay, your mind can't understand if it's real or not. So if you consistently say that I've smashed two females and I smashed this girl, this H-O, right? Or how do you say it? H-O-E. Yeah, ho? Okay, yeah, ho, right? And you consistently call her that, even in the music video, you can try to go a year of semen retention, but if you are coming in agreement with that rapper talking about the lustful actions towards a female, right, and not respecting the female in a way where you're calling her outside of her name, brother, it's going to be tough for you to go and respect females. It's going to be tough for you to respect yourself, you know what I mean, and respect your life force, bruh. So be careful with the music that you listen to, honestly. It's going to be tough, but transition to listening to maybe instrumentals, maybe gospel music. You know what I mean? So be very cognizant with what you put inside of your brain. I know it can be tough because the beats and everything, but be careful. And I know that was a little outside of the topic, but again, the vision. So that goes with what you're watching. Guys, there may be some YouTube channels out there that can, that talks about females and the lustful actions towards the females and, you know, and how they are promoting the act of creating a lustful action towards a female, right? Guys, that's what I decided to watch, okay? I let my mind get comfortable, and I decided to watch that. I'm going to be very honest with you, man. So the past couple of days, I decided to watch it, man. And guess what happened? Surprisingly enough, my vision on females, they almost changed. They literally almost changed. Like, you know, you can be this respectful guy, so on and so forth, but you still must take the action to protect your vision. Be careful with what you watch on the YouTube channel. If the YouTube channels are promoting creating a lustful action towards females, guys, more than likely, okay, if you keep putting that vision, this is creating a vision inside of you. And you know the power of visualization. They did a study. Remember, they did a study where the basketball players, the 10 basketball players, they didn't practice shooting. They only visualized themselves getting better. Well, this one did not. This group did not visualize, but they practiced getting better. The two groups came together after 30 days, and guess what happened? This group increased their free throw shooting by 23%, and this group increased it by 24%. So that's almost even. So when you put something inside of your brain and you see that and you come in agreement with that, right? You add feeling to it, then let's be honest here. It's going to be very tough for you to really go on the semen retention journey if you keep watching a person talking about creating a lustful action towards a female. And that's what happened to me, okay? And my vision almost changed a little bit because I kept seeing that and I came in agreement with that, okay? So be careful. Be careful with what you listen to. And that's what happened, right? And again, so guys, I hope this helped. I really do hope this helped. So the things that you must change and the things that you must implement on the semen retention journey, again, from day one to a lifestyle, is being careful with what music that you listen to. Be careful with what you see that you put inside of your mind. Be careful with what you view. And be careful if you come in agreement with that view, okay? And yeah, man. So look, man, if you guys get something out of the video, be sure to like the video and also... guys, subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. Again, we're going to be doing spiritual, mental, physical, and also financial growth in the channel. Okay, so I'd love to help you guys out. And comment down below your experience on the semen retention journey. Okay? But look, you guys take care. I'll catch you all in the next video. Peace.